Coyotes, welcome back to CMS TV.
Caitlin, we're live, wake up!
Welcome back to CMS TV.
Hope you enjoyed the 4-day weekend and the 4-day week. Some people obviously needed the sleep.
I know I did.
We've got some great stories for you guys today. But first, she's Caitlin.
And she's Ella.
And this is CMS TV.
I wanna take you to my paradise. One chance and we'll dance all night. Party. This feeling's right. This feeling's right. Let's dance all night. Dance all night.
We have some skater boys going down to the skater shop talking about skating.
Hey Coyotes, we skated down to Asylum Skate Shop in Oceanside.
So the store's been open for about like 15 years now. We started with the surf shop over there actually about like 20 years ago. And then they opened up this location about 15 years ago. So at Asylum, our biggest sellers for sure are going to be all our skateboards. Probably like our best brand would be Baker Skateboards. So what makes Asylum stand out from any other skate shop is that all of my employees here, we all skateboard, so we know exactly what to give you when you're looking for a board. And we have a great team, bunch of team riders that all ride for us, and our location right here by the beach.
Skaters, bro.
No. If you're familiar with Bob Ross, then you would be happy to know that we have our own CMS Bob here.
Really?
Poo! Well, duh, it's Miss Gerhardt. If you want to know more about the art electives, then let's keep watching.
Hey Coyotes, I'm Caitlin, and I'm here with Ms. Gerhardt to talk about the art elective here at CHMS. So, why did you choose this position to be an art elective teacher?
So, Mr. Ecker actually came to me with the opportunity and asked me if I would be interested in teaching art, and I said 100%, of course I am interested in that opportunity. When I was in college, I actually minored in art, and that, you know, it's just been a passion of mine since I was just a little tot.
Alrighty, now what are some creations that your students has made and what is your favorite?
So I believe we're gonna do a cast over with the images, but some of the projects that we've worked on and some of the projects that you'll see right now are Notan, which is a Japanese form of manipulating paper in such a way that you can observe the positive and negative space. We have some cultural masks that were done with the medium of using an oil pastel palette. We had students make icons that represented their 2019 resolutions for the new year. And then the last thing you'll see are Zentangle projects where they actually looked at an object and without looking at their paper, they drew in a form that's called blind contour and then they filled in that shape with Zentangle. So very neat examples, and these are excellent works of my students.
Awesome. So when are we going, is there opportunities when we get to see those arts?
Of course. So throughout the year, different art projects will be displayed. There's actually a display that's been up in the front office for Campbell's soup cans that we did as part of a project on pop art and studying Andy Warhol. The Spring Arts Festival is another time that you will be able to see some of the work that we are working on. But anytime you're able to stop by and check out what we have going on, fifth period is when the class is taught, so you're more than welcome to pop in, say hi.
That's awesome. I'm Caitlin, signing off.
Caitlin, does your dog ever get dirty?
Well, yes, it does. But I never can find a good groomer's place.
Well, Bella and Quincy have a solution to your problems with a story about Dirty Dogs.
So this is Dirty Dogs. Here at Dirty Dogs, we offer self-washes for dogs. We also do full grooming experiences. We do offer a wide selection of dog food.
What dog shampoos do you have?
So here at Dirty Dogs, we offer four different types of shampoos. They're all natural shampoos.
What are some of the struggles of washing dogs' hair?
We just kind of have to push through it. It's more than anything, some dogs like to be just talked to, almost kind of like a baby. For example, different breeds like a husky, they do not like baths. So no matter what you do, they're just gonna be howling and crying. Just gotta try to talk to them. And some dogs like to be held. Some dogs just like to be pets.
Wow, those dogs are squeaky clean.
Maybe I'll bring my dog there.
You don't have a dog.
Then I'll get one.
Enough talk about dogs.
Enough roughing around.
Oh gosh. Okay then, next we have some announcements.
Taylor, spill that tea.
Hey Coyotes, I'm Taylor Lomar for the weekly announcements and sports. On this week's agenda, running club, keep practicing on Thursdays from 2 to 3. And Tuesdays from 3 to 4. Oh, make sure to check out card making at lunch on the 26th. Also on the 26th, there's a spring concert that starts at 6:45. Make sure to check it out. Congratulations to everyone that made honor roll and the honor roll breakfast. If you want to go to the honor roll breakfast, it's on March 8th and it starts at 7:45. Have a great week in Coyotes, and I'll send it back to the anchors at the desk.
Caitlin, come on, we're recording here.
Oh, sorry, I was listening to Thank You, Class.
Oh.
But do you want to hear and see what the hype is all about?
Hello, welcome back to the broadcasting room.
We filmed this video explaining why you're not seeing Thank You, Class, the parody of Thank You Next by Ariana Grande,
about right 10 now. Times in 10 different rooms.
So here, just for that hard work, we're gonna put in a little montage.
Yeah, of all the bad audio. Okay, now that you've enjoyed that, we're going to talk about why we're not doing the actual parody.
Yes, and it has something to do with the audio as well, which is why we showed you those clips.
Yeah.
When we decided to do this parody, we had to write our own lyrics, which means we had to sing our own lyrics.
Which meant it was a long time of recording lyrics.
Which meant that when we put it in the timeline, it didn't add up to what we thought it would sound like, and it sounded a little something like this.
Class, gotta stay in that range, or else I won't pass.
You're welcome. We're not making you sit for 3 minutes of that. We won't do that to you. But instead, we're going to have Miss Ariana Grande singing Thank You Next put over our clips that we filmed.
Because we didn't want to waste all the clips of you guys and the teachers that we got dancing and having fun. So we turned it into a tribute. So
yeah.
Thank you, class. Thank you, next. Tribute for CHMS.
Yeah.
So
without further ado, let's roll the clips.
Top of the video. We don't have all day. Let's get this started. And action.
Thought I'd end up with Sean, but it wasn't a match. Wrote some songs about Ricky. Now I listen and laugh. Even almost got married. And for Pete, I'm so thankful. Wish I could say thank you to Malcolm, cause he was an angel. One taught me love, one taught me patience, and one taught me pain. Now I'm so amazing to have loved and I've lost. That's not what I see. Look what I got, look what you taught me. Yeah, for that I say thank you, next, next, thank you, next, next, thank you, next. I'm so grateful for my ex.
Thanks for watching, Coyotes, and I hope you have a great weekend.
Bye! Bye.